Is he gonna say Slammin' Sam? No.
Alright, that's the mashup. Gonna go ahead and start the show. Hang tight, everyone.
Virtual Entertainment Programming Network, TVEPN.com. Studios, The Slam Show. And now, your host, Slam.
Yes, welcome everyone for another edition of The Slam Show for July 1st, 2013. I am the main guy that runs this whole shebang, even on a 3 freaking million degree weather studio. Yes. We have to make it happen. I don't know where to start. First off, it's fucking hot. It is straight hot in the studio.
Hey, no, Slam.
Yeah.
You think?
Well, it's hot enough where Stallion, he's kind of disabled right now because of it. Yeah, it is bearing
110 in here.
It's enough to melt your shoes.
That's why you don't wear clothes. Unfortunately, it's not an X-rated show, so we have to wear clothes.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That's right. Well, I'd like to thank everyone for tuning in, everyone in the chat room from Niner Empire. Everyone, if you want to get a shout-out, just type in your name. We'll go ahead and do our best to give you a little plug. And as I always do, I'd like to have my co-hosting staff introduce themselves.
I'm the lovely Lady Sage.
Mr. Bad Karma.
DJ Stallion.
And our special guest co-host.
Truth is Girl, Mr. Philippine News, Bang Bang.
Mr. Philippine News.
Did you just
create that title for yourself?
I don't know, people have been calling me that. You know, some people don't really know my name because they know my report, so they're like, Philippine News. And then one time, you know, like I was just walking around MGM and they're like, hey, you're the Philippine News guy. I'm like, oh yeah, I am.
Huh? See, you're fucking famous, man. We're so freaking honored to have you here.
Yeah, you can believe it.
There you go, fist pump.
Oh, man.
And also in the studio, our special guest, she hails from the city of Sacramento. Basically, she does everything across the board. Let's just call her a Renaissance woman. Let's have a big round of applause for Victoria Valentine.
Woohoo! Mabuhay.
Oh!
Whoa.
I'm practicing my Filipino.
There you go.
Did you just say what? Mabuhay.
Oh.
Live long and prosper.
There you go. That's Star Trek.
Exactly. It's all about the Star Trek. How you doing, girl?
Pretty good.
That's cool. Thank you for being able to join us. And you brought your partner in crime, Ren.
Miss Ren.
Miss Ren. And you don't really see it, ladies and gentlemen, but she is very crippled at the moment due to a extreme accident.
She got in a fight, you know. She was, you know, she kicked someone real hard and, you know, broke that person's nose, but she, you know, she suffered a ankle injury somehow.
Yeah.
Thank you, doctor.
What you guys don't realize, this is the hottest math teacher in the 209.
Really?
Yes.
Oh. Okay.
She teaches math in a high school, so she's like the hottest in the 209.
All right.
Yeah.
All right.
Whoa, okay, Sam and I looked at each other because we can't do math. We're like, oh my God. Should we?
She comes with me everywhere.
Everything adds up to 69.
Should we
Sam.
Take a course?
Miss Wren will teach you. She has a foot to prove it.
That's too much, guys. But yeah, we got a whole incredible show stored for you guys. We're going to do our best to fight through this super heat because obviously there's a heat wave going on here in the San Francisco Bay Area, practically all of Northern California, except for one area, which is South San Francisco, Daly City, which for some unexplained reason always is cloudy and always the coldest.
There's
place.
Probably a vortex there. We just don't know.
I agree. I agree 100%. But overall, we're going to make it happen, and it's going to be a fun show. It's I can't wait to get into the meat of everything. So as we always do, we have our recap from the previous week, and let's go ahead and start off at Wednesdays over at Panetta's Hump Night. Always a good place, $2 drinks over here in Pittsburgh. If you guys haven't been there, check it out, Panetta's on Wednesday. Friday, there was a event that we are continuing to support. It is Empire over at Hamachi's, and DJ Stallion was there to rock the house because I was out on assignment. How was that gig?
It was good, man. It was a pretty good night. It was about 60-70 people, and they kept going throughout the whole night.
Whoa, there
yeah,
you go.
Yeah,
there you go. We're trying to make it happen. It's a new place over in Walnut Creek. And on Saturday, I was back over at Panetta's, usual stuff. Good crowd, good fun. And that's pretty much it on our end, Sage and I. Anything else you want to add on to that, Stellan?
Actually, let me backtrack. Remember okay. Last week on our show, I said, I'm going to do absolutely nothing and rest. And so that's what I did. And I loved it. I mean, I'm refreshed. I'm ready to go. Gym tomorrow. And that's that.
There you go. We need someone to pick up the slack because because good old Stallion is going to be on cruise control for the remainder. So
yes,
that's how we have to do it. Pick up each other's weaknesses on particular points of the show. So anything else, Stallion?
Saturday, I was supposed to go to the freestyle concert. And then I like fell asleep and woke up at 7:30.
I think that's when it started at 7:30.
Yeah, I did. So I was way on Filipino time. But yeah, I didn't even end up going. It was too damn hot out. And I was like, F this. And Magic Matt was hitting me up. Dude, the tickets are still on the mat. And I was like, man, I'm sorry, dude. I fell asleep, woke up. And that was it.
All good. All yeah. good. They're always going to do some type of freestyle festival.
Well, who was performing?
Sam's favorites. Stevie B, Lisa, yeah, Shannon.
There you go.
Wait, when was this?
Saturdays.
Oh.
You didn't get the memo?
Well, I was in L.A., so.
Since 1980.
Stevie B. You got a BlackBerry. I forgot you didn't get the memo.
Oh. So, Truth, what'd you do? Speak into the mic, please.
What's it called? I took a business trip down to L.A. I was covering a Miss...
Up to L.A.?
Down to L.A. What's it called? Covering the Miss Philippines USA. It's a fashion show.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
It was, yeah, so the whole Fan TV crew went down there and we covered, contestants and whatnot. And mm-hmm. Shouts out to Stephanie Laxamana. You know, she's doing her thing down there. So, yeah, you know, I was like, fashion show? Oh, man.
So
you
came in
third?
I didn't know
what to expect.
You came in third?
Who?
You.
Me? I didn't compete in the fashion show.
You said Miss Philippines, so.
Oh, man, look at this. Low blow
it's,
after
it's
low blow.
It's the heat.
Blow
it's the heat.
Low blow.
I'm blurred lines right now.
But, you know,
so, Truth, did you sneak into the dressing room?
You know, I had all access pass, but, you know.
Fast Olsen.
But your boy got to stay on duty. So, you know, I was interviewing, you know, I was,
being professional.
Things.
Yeah. So, who won?
It was a fashion show, so it wasn't really it was the designers that won because they got to show off their brands
okay.
and whatnot. But
gotcha.
You said Miss Philippines, and I was thinking it was a pageant.
Well, the pageant's in the 18th, but the it was just a fashion show, so
I
it was
see.
Just to see if the girls could walk the runway and whatnot. And yeah, it is what it is. But,
all good, all good. Victoria,
cool. Yes.
How was your weekend?
Pretty well. I'm What did I do this weekend? I have no idea. Oh, I had my children.
Okay. Okay.
I have so many of them.
Yeah. All at once?
Yeah. I had my children this weekend.
All right.
Did mom stuff. Did some family parties and stuff like that.
There you go. There you go. That's always exciting.
Family time is the most important time.
Yes. Yes.
Even though Truth doesn't have one yet.
Well, yeah.
Well, technically, as far as like your offspring, but you got your parents.
Yeah, you know, I chill with my mama.
You go out to the clubs and start.
Go to your mom, your dad, your cousins, your brothers, sisters.
Yeah, I go grocery shopping.
Guess I'd be family too.
That's too much. That's too much.
Oh my gosh, these guys.
Oh, we're on a roll, bro. Bingo. We're on a roll. Coming up this week, once again, Wednesday Hump Night over at Panetta's. $2 drinks. You don't want to miss that. Friday, I'll be over at Wild Idol Saloon in Byron. Yes, it is a cool place. If you haven't been there, check it out. And DJ Stallion will be over at Hamachi once again. For more information, go to our Facebook pages or the TV EPN Slam Show profile and get all the information there. All the guest lists and all that good stuff. All right, we're going to go ahead and take a quick commercial break and be back with the sports and entertainment segment here on the Slam Show. Hang tight.
Here we go.
Business cards. Wires. Graphic design.
Graphic design.
Marketing and advertising. Visit us at www.baymanda.com or give us a call at 650-571-5100. Baymanda offers 5,000 UV coated club flyers starting at just $99.99. Place your orders today for rock bottom prices. Baymanda.com.
And now you know who's best.
If your child is not breathing, roll them onto their back. Check airway is not blocked. Gently tilt head back, hold nose and breathe twice into mouth, place heel of hand in center of chest, and push down 15 times. Repeat breathing and chest massage until help arrives. If your child is...
You know how to help your child if they've stopped breathing, but do you know how to help them if they have a drug problem? Visit drugfree.org for information, help, and advice. This message brought to you by the partnership at drugfree.org.
Quality never goes out of style. And the quality of the Paul Frederick White Pinpoint Oxford dress shirt at just $19.95 will make it the staple of your wardrobe. This special introductory offer won't last forever, so act now to get the quality, comfort, and style you can only get from the Paul Frederick White Pinpoint Oxford dress shirt. Order today and receive free monogramming, a $9.75 value. Go to 1995shirt.com and enter promo code COLLAR. That's 1995shirt.com, promo code COLLAR.
This season, take tailgating to the next level with Mr. and Mrs. T Mixers. Hand off some Bloody Mary mix in original, bold, and spicy, and premium blend varieties. Delivering true made-from-scratch taste with game-day convenience. Mr. and Mrs. T Mixers promise perfect cocktails, even if the season isn't.
Goodyear presents awkward conversations between guys in cars.
So you admit you have tire amnesia?
Yes, I have tire amnesia.
Aha.
I do not remember what brand of tire I happen to have on my own car.
It's like you don't care.
Dude,
thing is, experts, people who really put their tires to the test, like NASCAR, they don't have tire amnesia.
But I'm not an expert.
Because NASCAR prefers Goodyear tires.
I'm not an expert.
Oh, and the first tires on the moon? Goodyears, chosen by NASA, heard of NASA?
Yes, will it make you happy if we pull over and see what kind of tires I have?
You don't have to. These Chevy Volts all come with Goodyear Fuel Max tires. They can help you save gas.
Wow, I have Goodyears?
Oh, so now you care.
Yes, I care. I care.
Goodyear, more driven. Receive up to $160 off with mail-in rebate when you buy four select Goodyear tires with your Goodyear credit card. Goodyear credit card purchases subject to credit approval. Certain conditions and restrictions apply. See retailer for complete details. Goodyear official tire of NASCAR. NASCAR is a registered trademark of the National Association for Stock Car Auto Racing Incorporated.
I tweeted all that stuff about that guy in the moment, you know? I never thought it'd be right there when you Googled him. I mean, it makes him look like, you know? Oh, I actually became a customer of his before he closed. Oh, man, the internet. You gotta stay on top of that thing.
On the internet, everyone is entitled to their opinion. Even this guy. That's why there's Reputation.com. Reputation.com understands that negative material about you online, no matter how untrue, could impact your reputation and your business. And you may never know the extent of the damage. Reputation.com helps you control how you look when people search you, managing reviews of your business, and pushing down misleading and malicious search results. Act now and get a free reputation assessment conducted by our expert advisors. Call us now at 800-283-1144. That's 800-283-1144, or go to reputation.com.
My name is Rania. As a little girl, I was told stories about witches, monsters, and the power of their evil. But then things changed. As I matured, I learned to harness and embrace that same energy for good. I guess I became what I was told to fear. I became a witch. And while I learned that not all monsters are to be feared, I know that there is a darkness, an evil waiting to devour us. I will use my everything to destroy it. And I'm not alone. I'm joined by Jenna, a vampirous gangbanger, and Jessica, a green-maned werewolf. We are the monsters breathing fear into the nightmare of every demon. We are the Shadow Hunters.
Follow the horror action comic book series Shadow Hunters at scatteredcomics.com. Like us on Facebook for updates of the Shadow Hunters live action movie.
Are you sick and tired of flies ruining your afternoon festivities? Well, look no further. Bug Assault's patented fly killing technology is a safe, simple, and effective way to vanquish these pesky creatures. Not only are flies notoriously dirty, they're fast. Its 3-foot range of use gives you the element of surprise over even the most adroit pests. With this innovative salt-powered device, you can keep pests at bay and enjoy your day. It's really simple. Fill it with ordinary table salt, then just pump, click, and hit. Because Bug Assault fires tiny granules of salt, there is absolutely no mess, making cleanup a cinch. Forget those inorganic sprays and rid your yard of unsightly traps. Bug Assault is a non-toxic and amusing alternative to traditional methods of insect eradication. It is perfect for barbecues, restaurants, warehouses, and households. We are so confident in the quality of our product that we offer a 30-day money-back guarantee. Take your freedom back. Order today.
Yes, welcome back to the Slam Show. This is a sports and entertainment segment sponsored by Lil J's Burgers, which they hooked up tremendously. Thank you, Aaron, for the good catering for this show. And the before mentioned Bug Assaults, they are actually, they went up on the totem pole as far as being able to be a great sponsor of the network. And Stallion, they're actually doing some promotion over in China, correct?
Yeah, they are. They went out there. I guess they're working with some the Chinamen. And
just say the China Republic of China.
Yeah,
how's that?
Yeah, they're working with the Chinese people.
He's just going through his flashes right now. So
I'm offended. I'm not Chinese, but I'm offended.
The Chinese.
They just have big pests over there in China, you know? They need some help, so, you know, bang, bang, they got to shoot.
You and your bang, bang
He's been
expressions.
Watching, like, Wayne's Brothers too much.
So, yeah, let's go ahead and get right into it. Oh, first off, we want to go ahead and congratulate our newest sponsor, Fruition Clothing. And Truth, you're the one that was able to hook it up for the network and the Slam Show. Talk about Fruition and what's about.
Fruition, you know, it's about it's a positive clothing brand, you know, dream, believe, achieve. And they believe, you know, Andrew and Jack and Marlon, you know, they come up with this design just to inspire people while wearing clothes. And it's, you know, it's really urban. It's pretty sick. It's still starting up, but, you know, I see their vision and it's pretty dope.
That's cool. And that's why I decided, hey, we got to give them a shot. And yeah, see what they can do, because it's all about positivity. And it's a very interesting logo, because it's basically what, a tree?
Karate Kid.
Yeah, it's a bonsai tree.
Bonsai tree,
that's
there you go.
That's what I was going to say.
You know, bonsai tree is very fragile, you know, like kind of like a dream, and you have to be, you know, very precise and stuff like that and take care of it.
Yeah.
You know, so it is what it is. It's pretty dope, and yeah, hopefully they, you know, they could push it through and whatnot.
Well, we're going to do our best to nurture the relationship we have and make it happen for fruition. So once again, much props out to Andrew and the rest of the company. Thank you very much. And I have mine on. The rest of the guys, it's freaking too damn hot for them to switch clothes. So it's all good. They'll probably have it on next week.
I'll wear mine as a dress next week. Commando.
There you go. There you go.
Just kidding.
All right, moving on to our first topic. We never discussed the whole Aaron Hernandez thing until I wanted to get a real meat on all sorts of information. And
wasn't that your pick in fantasy?
It would have been my sleeper pick. Would have been. Because Gronkowski... Because
he puts people to sleep?
No.
Oh.
No. I forgot you were the one that finished last in last year's one. Oh, it was all good.
And I never played before. Oh, and I'm not gonna play this year. Oh.
Oh.
No comment on that.
Yeah, because if you're afraid of competition, that's all I gotta say.
I don't have the time, dude.
All right.
He's getting to his head right now.
All right, check it out.
He's salty.
He's currently jailed. He's awaiting trial. His hearing is gonna be, I believe, on July 24th. Now, the whole thing that's kind of stunning is that the Patriots went ahead and just let him go right off the bat, unlike certain teams that would kind of let the legal system play out, then make some action in regards to releasing the player or whatnot.
Like Ray Lewis, they kept him anyway.
Yeah, exactly. Kept Ray Lewis on, and that was what I think a team should. And karma, do you think it was kind of premature for the New England Patriots just say, okay, let's go ahead and wipe our hands clean and just not have to worry about him anymore? Because, hey, he was tremendous. He was tremendous on the field. He was one of the more efficient tight ends, a weapon for Tom Brady. And for them to just say, all right, well, you're alleged murderer. Enough is enough. We'll go ahead and let you go. Is it fair?
Yeah. I mean, and definitely, I think it's more of the morality standpoint of the Patriots.
Morality, yeah, the Patriot way.
The Patriot way. It's just, they actually said that they didn't even know today that he was actually charged in, what, two more murders, I believe?
Yeah, in 2012.
That he's been connected to so much more other... And did you hear the announcement that they had where they said that they realized the motive behind the whole murder was that they got in a fight in the nightclub.
Right.
The gentleman just got killed.
Yeah.
And it was because he was going to go forward and tell the police that Aaron Hernandez was involved in all these murders.
Yeah.
So, I mean, but they didn't announce that, and the Patriots didn't know that. But I think it was just a whole thing of saying, hey, we have somebody, connected to a murder. We're not going to be associated with that.
And, right, right.
You know, they're I really do give them credit for just having the, I don't want to say credit, but just saying, you know what? Just to cut them loose. It was probably to save their ass to say, I'm not paying this guy $40 million, although it will hit them.
Yeah, yeah. They took that approach knowing that they could go ahead and say, the contract says you have to abide by these clauses and just totally start fresh, make it happen, find someone that will just go ahead and replace and focus that going into training camp. Totally get that. And you know what was a cool thing is that, well, see, this is another thing that the Patriots ownership is kind of jumping on really quick, is the whole exchanging Aaron Hernandez jerseys for another player on the team equivalent. I don't think you could go ahead and, oh, here's my Aaron Hernandez jersey. Let me get a Tom Brady. I don't think it's on that level, but...
It has to be a tight end for a tight end, maybe?
Possibly. Or
grab what you want.
What about Tebow? Oh, yeah, I want that one.
I don't know. Do you think that qualified? Is that a fair?
That was actually one of the topics was that one of the big things was that opens a spot for Tim Tebow.
Exactly. Exactly. And have his opportunity there to be on the field because obviously he wants to play quarterback. We get that.
Yeah.
But you're talking about Tom Brady here. Unless Tom Brady and who is Ryan Mallett? He is the backup to Tom Brady. Unless they both go down
at the same time.
Tebow is not going to see the light a day when it comes to the football field at
honestly,
all.
Well, honestly, it's one of those things with Belichick that he has the, what do you call it, the moxie, the clout to go ahead and say that, you know what, if he walked up to Tim Tebow,
mm-hmm.
he says, look, he just holds up his hand, shows him his rings, says, look, you're not gonna be a quarterback in this league. If I cut you, because you want to be a quarterback, and I'm going to tell everybody in this, the other 29 teams in this league, that you're not going to be able to be a quarterback, you, trust me, no other team will ever sign you. So if I tell you to do what you need to do, you know, that's what you have to do to be in this league. And I believe that there are other, all the other coaches in the league will say, Bill Belichick said so, I'm going to follow what he says.
Okay, fair enough, fair enough. And get up to the mic real quick because it's you're kind of distancing.
Still not working very
there
well?
You go, there you go, perfect.
Okay, you can hear me?
Yeah.
But, I mean, yeah, it's going to be that Bill Belichick has that clout that he says that if you were not going to work in this league, that, you know, every other team will actually pay attention to what he says.
Yeah, because the Patriots are, I would say, they exemplify a certain standard of professionalism to a certain degree. Obviously, you have the whole Spygate and all that stuff.
Yeah, but every year you expect them to fight for the AFC Championship plus the Super Bowl Championship. You always expect them to be in the Super Bowl. If they don't win a championship, it's a failure to them. Just like 49ers now.
Exactly.
If they don't win a championship, it's a failure.
Oh, wow. We got Karma supporting the whole Niner element. Oh, thank you. Thank you.
You're the man. How did we jump from Aaron Hernandez to Niners, man? That's, I just saw it just jump ships.
Just say failures.
I just connect two failures.
Oh, okay.
Plus one equals three. That's what I'm looking at.
You're too much.
I mean, you and I had a discussion about Tebow. I think he'd be more successful in another position than a quarterback. Because you're right. What is he going to do? Be a third string and sit there? I want to see him in action.
But I know Belichick, he has some trick plays. Sometimes he does a trick play sometimes. So I could see him using Tebow in like one trick play.
All right.
One.
One per game, right?
No.
For the whole year?
One trick. They do trick plays. Belichick has trick plays.
Oh, He has a lot of crazy shit up his sleeve, for sure. So we'll see how this plays out. Karma, do you think this will go to trial early, or this will be kind of like an OJ thing, stretch out for months, maybe a year?
It's a plea bargain. This boy is going to get probably 25 to life.
Right.
There's so much around it. There's just so much that I think a lot of guys are going to get pulled into this, and they're just going to turn on him. Because he doesn't have enough money now to, you know, offer to his friends to protect his back.
Yeah.
There's no lifestyle for them. So I think they're just going to turn him in. They're going to get the publicity from, you know, book rights. Or also, all it's going to take is this one, you know, what's the British, like, the British tabloid?
BBC?
Sorry. Yeah, you know, the BBC. But you know what I'm talking about. It's one, what news network. Just going to say, you CNN, let's say, just for example, I know they won't, but okay, you're going to turn to a friend and say, I'm going to give you $1 million to go and tell me everything about you know about Aaron Hernandez.
Exactly.
You know, and they're going to tell him, and he's going to have to plea bargain down, and he's going to have nothing to fight against.
Here's the sad thing. He could have at least hired a hitman to take care of all that. What do you mean? He didn't have to freaking do it, man.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Pay me $1 million. He trust me, I would have gone to jail for you for 25 years. Take care of my family. You know, I would have
your million bucks is no good in jail.
What?
I said your $1 million is no good.
It's good for the family. That's, I mean, 25 years later.
Well.
Yeah, there you go.
There you go. You can hire this guy.
So we'll see.
I'm available.
We'll see.
Rubberbagkarma.com.
There you go. No domain name.
Hey, you don't Instagram pictures of the gun you kill the people with on Instagram.
No, you leave it there at the site.
Yeah, that's. Mr. Hernandez, you are in deep shit, so yeah, you're probably not watching the show, but yeah, you totally fucked up when you could have just hired a hitman. All right.
Or play for the Raiders.
Moving on to our next topic. Another failure situation. Disgraced chef Paula Deen has been dropped from her network, the Food Network, and other sponsors are just leaving this older lady out to dry because her racist comments stemming from back in the day, like 20 years ago, alleged racist remarks towards workers and people around her. But check this out. She was offered a six-figure gig from PureMature.com. Yes, PureMature.com is a MILF porn site.
It's not even MILF. It's mature. Mature, like old.
GILF.
Yeah. I mean, I Googled that and I nearly threw up in my mouth. I'm like, oh my God, is there really such thing?
Six figures. Now, obviously, there's no nudity involved, so it would be kind of like a Snoop Dogg thing where he presents, then they go into the sex scene, and there's a break, and presents
so
again.
She's like the madam?
Exactly.
Hey, y'all, it's Paula Deen, and next that's going to have sex is... I mean, that's going to be so annoying.
Yeah. Watch your face, take butter.
Yeah.
know what you gotta do, son? You make her happy. You gotta put some butter on it.
Butter
and bacon.
Well, check this out. We're thinking about, because that seems to be the trend now, when a celebrity wants to go ahead and make a quick buck, the Brazzers, Vivid, or something. Hey, would you like to be on our next porn, but you don't do any nudity? You're just going to put the label, the fonts, the description.
I want
to
do that job.
On the cover and present it. Victoria, would you do something like that where you're not doing any nudity, you're just presenting yourself like Victoria Valentin presents...
trickery.
Yeah, they're just using that presentation.
The name, your name.
Yeah, my name specifically, probably not.
Okay. But if you were...
I can see why people would want to do that. I mean, six figures, come on.
Right, right.
But, yeah, that's interesting.
Is it something... Oh, well, Sage already brought it up. Hell yeah. Real easy.
No
done
nudity.
Deal.
You just have
I
to,
mean,
like...
I mean, how much money has Paula Deen got stashed away anyways?
Paula Deen?
Yeah.
Who knows? It's probably underneath her...
Mattress,
knowing that that's the way she gets down. And it doesn't really fucking surprise me of the whole racist comments. I mean, you got to watch the show. You could tell she's just straight up Southern born, just undercurrent of freaking racism,
yeah,
just waiting to come out.
You know the backstory, right? When she was a bank teller, she was held up by an Afro-American gentleman, and mm-hmm. that stemmed the...
Yeah, I remember that.
She grew up in Oakland?
It's in Georgia somewhere, but that stemmed the I don't know if it's the hatred or the racism or whatnot, but
well, see, that's by choice. It's just like if you happen to get robbed by a certain culture, whether it's Afro-American or Asian, Mexican, just because you went through that experience, you don't label the entire culture and just say, okay, everyone's like that because of what had happened to me. So if that's her way of approaching her situation, all right, she has every right to do that, but it's very unfair. It's just being stereotypical, knowing, and then you're inherent towards looking at people in that certain way, because not everyone's going to be evil and not everyone's going to be what you perceive them to be. That's just the way it goes.
She's not even racist though. I mean, I think there was a report, but I remember there was a story where she helped this African-American kid get his business together and stuff mm-hmm. like that. So I think for me, this is what I think. I think it got blown out of proportion by the media. And I think it started with NBC, where she accidentally missed the show.
Mm-hmm.
And probably NBC, you know, tried to pile on and destroy this figure. That's what I think. You know, the media just wanted to destroy this figure. That's what I think.
And
it got blown out of proportion. That's what I see.
Well, just keep in mind, Paula Deen comes from a culture where it's easy to say the N-word and feel like you're not offending anyone because it's so natural.
But we can't stereotype those people, can we, Sam?
It's, there you go.
We all turn on KML. I mean, we hear that every day. So, I mean...
Well, not only that, but you got to remember that she has a... It's like Martha Stewart. She has an empire.
Yeah.
Okay, so she's the CEO. I mean, there's people underneath her that let things go because she doesn't know. I mean, trust me. I mean, if I went to Anheuser-Busch, who I'm a contractor with
right.
my company, you know, trust me, the VP or the president, or if Augie Bush came out to me, he wouldn't know who the hell I was. You know, so I could be doing anything in his name, saying I work for Budweiser, because that's people associate you with. But
right.
I don't actually work for Budweiser. I don't work for Anheuser-Busch. I'm a contracted out. And Paula Deen's probably in the same way. She has restaurants that are, you know, as you filter down,
right.
that there are people right above that may allow things to go or force things to go.
Exactly.
And she has no idea. It's just her name is on it.
Right,
her
right.
Her son's names are on it. You know, it's something that she can't control.
Well, see, you're coming from the angle that there are things that she can't control because of her empire, but this is actual words coming out of her mouth that she's being pointed out. So
yeah.
There's no connection to that, but I can see where you're coming from. Just like here on the Slam Show, we have so many sponsors that support us dearly, and we thank them to the highest heavens. So we're not going to go ahead and jeopardize by doing something questionable that makes them look in a bad light. And at the end of the day, we want to be able to continue putting this program together and representing good. Because if I slip up and I do a Paula Deen, boy, it's going to be awfully freaking trickle-down effect that everything's going to go haywire. So... it's too bad that it had to happen. Paula Deen had a great following, but unfortunately in this day and age, especially with the current situation that's happening, hey, you got to watch what you're saying. Just a little tiny hint of racism will always freaking come up into something big.
It's that political correctness, you know?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly, because there's a whole bunch of stuff I want to say to you, Truth, but I just can't. I can't.
Now they're going to do is all these people, they're going to go 20 years back and dig up all this dirt and sayings. Oh, you called me this 20 years ago, now I'm going to sue you.
That's right. That's basically what happened. But that's the thing that makes money become an evil, because Paula Deen is that empire. And, hey, what's a few checks written out to settle things? Oh, 50 grand, 100 grand, no big deal. Sign it off. So
which the sad part was that actually with her, she had a good PR, PR manager, and actually some good lawyers that this probably would never came to light.
Yeah, her PR team failed, like totally.
Yeah, they failed. But on the other hand, you know,
and her son's show's called what, this Ain't Your Mama's Cooking or something like that.
Yeah,
on Cooking Channel.
Yeah, but the sad part is it's actually somewhat in a good thing if you look at the truth of it. You know, it's actually a good thing that we can't always hide the truth just behind money or a PR publicity stunt. Saying that, oh no, this is not what she did. You actually learn the truth
exactly
about what people are actually saying. How they feel.
Yeah. Do you guys think that Paula Deen will get back on her feet?
No.
She's done.
I think she can. She has skill. If you got skill, you could still do something. She could cook, and she has a following, and she has creative meals. I seen some of their She deep fries everything. So.
That's right.
Yeah, but, you could
deep fry.
You could do that off of so many.
Let us put it on the Travel Channel or some other one.
Yeah. I mean, has Martha Stewart had her brand
Spike
come back
TV.
Yet?
That's right.
All she did was Insider Training.
Yeah,
that was it. I mean, she's still having problems come back. So.
She's still got our line, all of those things at Macy's and Walmart and everything else now. So
it just goes back down to what you guys are saying. The PR team, if they're able to set up and protect her from this point on, it's just like Kobe. It's just like Tiger Woods. You could totally screw up, but then be resurrected and have a new beginning. So we'll see if her PR team and
Michael Vick.
Yeah. So we'll see. Paula Deen, we wish you the best.
Yeah, just take the gig. You'll be fine. What is it again? PureMature.com?
Exactly.
Take it.
All right, on our final topic, dropping July 4th is Jay-Z's newest album called Magna Carta Holy Grail. Yeah, it just has Illuminati written all over it. And basically, he's starting a new trend. And this is a great idea. The full album will be available to all Galaxy S3, S4, and Note 2 users. So basically, you just go onto the Google Store, download it, and boom, you already have the album. And this thing has been kind of blowing up everywhere on the internet, on regular networks. You're seeing the black and white infomercials where it shows freaking Jay-Z rambling on about, oh, we gotta create the new rules because no one's done it and a nobody could go ahead and be a somebody. Jay-Z, he is a mogul, give him props and stuff like that, but he's in no freaking position to start spitting science when he doesn't know what the fuck he's talking about. If you watch the freaking commercial, it makes you wonder, did they just go ahead and allow him to just ramble on a whole bunch of misleading wording and stuff like that? I think you want to go ahead and make a promotional infomercial about your album. Just say, okay, we got the producers, Rick Rubin's on it, Pharrell, Swiss Beats, Timbaland. But make it to where it's simple and it's presenting the album. Don't freaking start having this philosophy about, yeah, we gotta do it like this, and we're gonna take it to a whole new level. No shit. That's the reason why you're a mogul, because you've kind of rejuvenated the whole hip-hop culture. But don't go out there thinking that you're a teacher or anything and start preaching, because it doesn't make a whole hell of a lot of sense. But outside of that, it was a great idea to go ahead and have the album automatically downloadable on Samsung gadgets, because hey, that's automatic sales, done deal. You could hit platinum just by that type of download. So I think it's the wave of the future, where you will have a smartphone and from that app you get the whole album, whether it's free, whether it's for 99 cents. That's the wave of the future, guys, straight up. Just
the idea from iTunes that's been doing it for the last how many years.
Yeah, well, that's iTunes.
Yeah, it's just as easy to do it at iTunes. You can go on our show and listen. We go down to iTunes, you put an album in, you can do the whole album the same way. So I don't know why he's limiting out iTunes when there are billions and billions of people and downloads. a lot more than an Android.
Remember, it was a whole strategy by saying it's on Samsung gadgets. That's the whole key.
Well, maybe he's contracted with them and he's pushing
there you
that.
Go.
It's
exactly.
He's piggybacking off the what is it called? The network.
Yeah.
It's called front-loading a contract. That's all it is.
Yeah.
That's right. That's
it's
right.
It's like a guaranteed contract.
Affiliated. That's the word. They're affiliated. Exactly.
A signing bonus. That's what it is.
And it's a great idea because if you're able to partner up with a certain line and just say, okay, through this smartphone or through this gadget, you could have my whole album, that not only enables sales to come up front through that gadget, but you're getting the residual through the plays that you're generating from that device.
Yeah. Not only the device, but the brand. It's branding. That's all
yes.
it is.
Mm-hmm.
We got six people here. Do you know what alcohol beverage that Jay-Z is associated with right now? Anybody? Six people here.
Hennessy? No.
Go ahead.
I don't know.
I know you don't drink, but...
No, you had some before you came here, so let us know.
So, I mean, no, it's Budweiser. Believe it or not, Budweiser is actually the sponsor of Jay-Z. How often have you seen that commercial?
That's right.
Yeah, because they had to pay him every time they play that commercial.
Yeah.
So it's all about branding. That's all it is.
The branding is very important.
He's now branding with Samsung. And the whole thing is like, oh, yeah, you get the free album, whether you want it or not. You know, you could always have it for free. They know they're going to pay it for iTunes, like Stanley was saying before. So it's for him. It's a smart idea just by being front-loaded with the money. Because he can say that it's my name, that you got to pay me for my name, my brand. And that's all it is. He's making brands right now, and that's how big he is right now.
Yeah, and he could experiment. He could go ahead and try different angles of promotion and make that happen. So much props, and we'll see how it goes.
Does anyone here have a Galaxy, Samsung, whatever?
Does anyone? No? Yes?
Oh, yes.
Yes? Ren, you have one? You're going to download it on July 4th?
So he's got one sale out of
him. He got one over here.
He's got, yeah.
But he's alien. But isn't. But at the same time,
Magna Carta.
Isn't he alienating? Isn't he alienating the other users?
In a way, because you're kind of saying, hey, you could only do it on this particular brand. But that's the way the whole contract goes. We'll see how it plays out. That's going
to
be important.
Is it exclusive to Samsung? Like all the S4,
Galaxies.
The Galaxies, yeah. S3, so it's exclusive.
You can't get it on iTunes at all?
So if I have iTunes, I can't even buy the album for like...
You can buy it. You can buy it on iTunes, but you just can't do the free download.
Okay.
So Victoria.
So you actually make somebody buy like a $500 phone just to get a free download of...
Exactly.
Okay.
Free download when you buy a six-pack. It's like on the side, a sticker. You have to go on there and get your free download.
What you can do.
Are you going to get the album?
Yes.
Not.
Oh, you're not really a Jay-Z fan?
I am occasionally, like some songs, but.
Name one.
Oh, God.
I'll Be with Foxy Brown.
So nice.
Wait, is this the album that's like long awaited by everybody that hasn't gone come
no,
out
that's
yet?
You're talking about Dr. Dre's Detox.
Oh, okay.
Detox. Yeah.
That will never come
Sorry.
Out.
That will never, ever, ever.
In 30 more years.
Come out.
Uh-huh. It's when Suge Knight gets shot and killed and Tupac arises back, then he's going to put him on the album. That's how it's going to come out.
It's going to come out on hologram. Yeah. Oh,
you guys are too much. All right.
And it's free on iTunes for everybody.
Oh, it comes with Dre beats.
There you go.
Beats.
Oh, when you buy some headphones.
Yeah, you have to buy the Dre headphones.
They're built in. The album's built into the headphones when you buy it.
That's an idea.
Dre, baby.
That's a straight up idea. All
just
right.
Gave him an idea, Stallion. You better trademark that.
Yeah.
We're going to go ahead and take a quick break. This is the mix time with our resident DJ, Scoop. We'll be back in 20 and have our special guest, Victoria Valentin, Renaissance woman, talk about what she got's planned and happening. Stay tuned here on The Slam Show.
This is the DJ you've been waiting for. Now get ready to rock with DJ Scoop.
Already got one rolled up in my left hand. In my left hand. You're my mind tighter than a headband. Then my lungs got gunk in my sweat glands. I'm on better than the next strand. Then the next strand, better than the next strand. Aye. She head down, booty popping in the handstand. I shine bright, I give your girl a slight tan. I make that whistle like the Old Spice man. I don't even understand why she'd ever want a man. If she ever throw it, I catch it like a cornerback. Like a cornerback, that's an interception. You think I give up? That's a misconception. Oh,
what a night. Yeah. Oh, what a night. Yeah. The roof is on fire. Yeah. So what? I'm high. Yeah. I say, oh, what a night. Hey. Oh, what a night. Hey. Yeah, she a bad, bad, bad. All jokes aside. Hey, look at baby over there. What's up? Little mama come here. She started talking, but I really couldn't hear her. Till she started dancing like she do it in the mirror. Like she do it in the mirror. Like she do it in the mirror. She broke it down, started moving like she care. Like she do it in the mirror. I chop one, chop two, chop that out. Down, down, chop that out. Down, chop, chop that out. Down, all I want you to do is just drop that out. Down, drop that out. Down, now look back at it. Whistling Dixie, middle school, I was getting on the 10 speed. Gigolo Bloodline, pimping the Hereditary. Black on 28, it remind me of February. There you can fool me, that would be never wearing. Dead, dropper should have came with a cemetery. I am so cold. Look like Ben and Jerry, feeling the Dylan, but killing the obituary. My vision blurry, these flirting. I've been drinking all night, I think my kidney's hurting. Damn. So I close the curtains on the 62. Hot the knock your ass out, you better stick and move. Bro. Chain hang to my relane. Chain hang to my relane. To do a threesome, you gotta intervene. Her legs so sexy when I'm in between. Hey, look at baby over there. What's up? Little mama come here. She started talking, but I really couldn't hear her. Till she started dancing, how she do it in the mirror. How she do it in the mirror.
Down the highway, nothing for me to do but smoke as if it's a Friday. Break it down, spread it out, now roll up, and let's see what they about. Call them up. Ludacris, Maddie's on my last name. Sip slow, but I'm driving all in the fast lane. Get them by my way, man. Move. Quit yapping if you never wanna do. I'm all about it, get your mind right. Been making money since before I was in the limelight. Grind right. What's up? Top down, but I feel like I'm good. I get, but the bass low. A real, but your woman wanna shake for. When you shake it for a baller, better shake it right. Cause it's about to be a hell of a night.
Won't leave me alone. He knew that.
looking for a girl like you. So already settled down and loyal to your door. You got your eyes on me, girl, he got his eyes on you. My eyes are on this money and it's nothing he can do. He ain't fly, no. He don't even drive, no. That's why you call him my phone. It won't leave. To my team, you got your eyes on me, and girl, I got my eyes on green. You're near, he's so bummy, need to boost his self-esteem. He ain't fly.
Just split your head so hard that your hat can't fit you. Either I'm with you or against you. Format bent you. Back through that maze I sent you. Puppet to the rap inventor. Nigga with the game type fifth that flame right. Spell my name right. B-I-double-G-I-E. Iced out, lights out. Me and Caesar Leo. Getting mad for some chick he know. See, it's all about the cheddar. Nobody do it better. Going back to Cali strictly for the weather. Women and the weed. Sticky green. No seeds, bitch, please. Papa ain't soft. Up in the hood, ain't no love lost. Got me mixed up, you drunk the licks up. Mad cause I got my dicks up. And my balls lick, forfeit, the game is mine. I'ma spell my name one more time, check it. It's the M-O-T-O-R-I-O-U-S. You just lay down slow. Recognize a real dawn when you see one. Sipping on booze in the house of blues. I'm going back, back to Cali, Cali. In the west, smoke some nice sets in the west. Y'all niggas is domestic and I won't stop. Give it LA props. All I gotta beef with those that violate me. I shall annihilate thee. Case closed, suitcase could be closed. Linens and things, I begin things. People start to flash. 818-213-313s. B-I-G, frequently floss holes at Roscoe's. If I wanna squirt her, take it a fat burger. Spend about a week on Venice Beach, sipping Cristo with some freaks from Frisco.
Through my heart, why you let these wolves tear what we had right apart? Oh, I'm so mad. I could have seen this coming right from the start. You should beware, beware, beware of a woman with a broken heart. Okay, ski, smoke, sleep, call, miss, text, woke, spoke, lie, feel, Lisa, ill, time, kill, months, still. I got somebody, baby mama, calling me daddy. I drank too much, please call me a cabbie. Swerve. Penthouse after party, want the addy. Swerve. They could ride with us, crawling the caddy. Third row, that's when you call, I hit cancel. Really, I hit answer, I hate when that happens. Phone in my pocket for the whole night. And you heard, just screaming till my phone died. Then she text me like, why you still talk to my mama? How the f*** you run around with condoms? Why you made me get this tattoo? Man, this tattoo. You the reason I wasn't single in college. What, all because I had you? I don't even have you. How I'm supposed to get past you? And she called the next guy, spilling some real. Now they problems that he gotta deal with. When you said it was over, you shot right through my heart. Why you let these wolves tear what we had right apart? Ooh, I was so mad. I could have seen this coming right from the start. You should beware, beware, beware of a woman with a broken heart. Girl, don't believe them, cause they don't wanna see us together. And you already know you're too fly. But baby, don't get your hair caught in the propellers. I be trying to tell her these jealous. You know they never like it when you never say never. Long hair, red bone, but a is hairless. Why, I French kiss it like we in Paris. I be screaming out, ain't no woman like the one I got. But she be always worrying about the one I f-. She says it's gonna be me, myself, and I. Damn, that'll make me a one I f-. I was so mad. Damn, you used to ride it like a moped. But players fuck up, my bad. And just to keep from crying, I laughed. When you said it was over, you shot right through my heart. Why you let these rules tear what we had right apart? Oh, I was so mad. I could have seen this coming right from the start. Hey, you should beware, beware, beware of a woman with a broken heart.
Let's get down, let's get down, let's get down. Come on. we can do it at my house. My front door is open so homies get busted out. And ladies, if you come and leave your children at the nursery so you get slow on the anniversary. Feel me, I dip, dip, die. So don't be looking stupid when I unfasten your bra. You know you wanna Mac this because I come stronger than the IRS whenever you done got the late one on your taxes.
Now here I am, staring at you.
That was The Mix Time featuring our resident mix master DJ Scoop. If you want more mixes, downloads, all that good stuff, go to djscoop.com. He is the man. Thank you very much for hooking it up. That's a little classic tune, The After Party. All right, let's go ahead and move on with the show, and this is the special guest segment. Let's throw up a quick slideshow of her work.
Oh my.
Yes, she is. This is the cool thing. Her whole modeling career is not what it seems in terms of something that's been long lasting throughout the years. She actually is a newcomer, but has a very a respected background. And you're probably saying, all right, well, exactly what you're trying to say, Slam. All right, I'll explain to you. She basically is doing everything underneath the entertainment umbrella, making stuff happen. Once again, let's have a big round of applause for Victoria Valentine. Woo! All right, this is your moment to shine, girl.
Here we go.
All right, let's get into it. The reason why I broke it down like that was you are not a youngster, but people think that you are, and you're proud of everything that you've accomplished to this point. Let's just be very transparent and candid. How old are you?
Oh my, I thought you were
going to
ask.
Bang, bang.
I know, it's crazy because, well, see, here's the thing. We're not going to get past, like, the other personal stuff. Uh-huh. So we might as well just go ahead and be very
candid about it
because it makes people out there that are your age saying, wow, this is impressive. I could do it.
Yeah,
so let's go ahead and...
Well, let's just tell a little story. One of my students said, Miss Victoria, how old are you? Are you 24? And I said, yeah, I'm 24. Let's add about another 15 years to that or maybe more. Yeah, I'm getting close to 40.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. And that's the thing. When you look at her, there's really, it's amazing. It's amazing. And that's the thing that's kind of in a connection with Sage here, and we're going to kind of mesh things together as we develop the interview.
don't tell my age.
But,
I will kill you.
The whole idea is that you started in this industry not long ago. No. How did you get involved?
Well, I've always wanted to get into this as a young teenager. And as a young mother, I became a young teenage mom. It was something that I thought, oh, wow, now how am I going to get into something like this? It was, as years went by, I started thinking, wow, that's something that's never going to happen.
Right.
It's just never going to happen. And it was something that was just deep within me, like, man, you know, how? And it's over now, you know? But it's one of those things where, honestly, a couple years ago, 3 years ago, I was kind of going through a rough spell in life. I had lost my job. I was... lost my home at the time. I had to move in with family, and it was one of those things where, what am I going to do? You know, the economy is going down. What's happening? It was just kind of a fluke thing. One of my friends, and I'll plug his name, Reggie Cavero.
Okay.
He's at the VU.
We know him.
Reggie. Yes. Reggie. Mm-hmm. And so he had said, hey, you know what, can you help promote one of my clothing, you know, designs? And I said, sure. He's like, come with me to one of the car shows in San Ramon. So that was like about 3 years ago.
Right.
And I said, sure, I'll wear one of your t-shirts. And from there, it was pretty cool, you know, taking pictures by beautiful cars and beautiful women. So I was like, this is pretty cool, you know, and it just kind of progressed from there. I met a great man that kind of took me under his wings, Kevin Moore with Royal Life Entertainment. He kind of showed me the business. And from there, I think I just got bit. And it was like, wow, what more can I do? How do I keep getting my hands into this? And just little by little, things have been coming up, and doors are opening, and it's just an amazing thing.
That's fantastic. That's fantastic, because the thing is this is starting to be the norm with a lot of women out there, where they basically have kids at an early age. They go through the parenting, the development, going into high school, and they kind of miss that point of their lives where, hey, I could have done that, but is it really actually past my prime? Yeah. And as long as you're able to keep everything intact and take
smile and wear a lot of makeup, everyone's like, oh, you know, you're so pretty. It's called makeup.
you're able to pursue your dreams. And congratulations on that, because that's the thing where, you know, you have that opportunity and basically a second chance in life to say, hey, I want to go ahead and do what I'm doing. I wish I was doing back when I was in my 20s. Mm-hmm. And I think that's important for you to go ahead and be successful at, even though it's 20 years later.
Yeah.
And that's a positive thing. In the short period of time, what have you been keeping yourself busy? Talk about your print work, magazines, stuff like that.
It's just, I've worked with great photographers a lot. I'm from the 209 Stockton area, originally born from San Jose, so I got to give it to the 408 and the 209. So I have great people within the local community that have been backing me up. Stockton has been great for me, pushing me. With everything that's happening with our city and communities, you know, bringing us down, and with Forbes and everything,
right.
I want to be that positive, you know, and there's a lot of positivity that happens. And so, like, there's a lot of photographers, Mike Byerly, Max Shot Photography, Frankenmuffin. There's just so many things that I've gotten my hands into.
Exactly. A lot of that, the photos that I did with the slide are top quality shots.
Yes.
And you're obviously connecting with some of the more professional elements when it comes to photography and so forth. Now, with the industry, what's your favorite part of it that you like doing?
Well, I'm a community person. I'm an educator. I work with children. I'm an after-school teacher. And so just being a positive light,
yeah.
You know, I have children myself. So just within the community, knowing that I'm doing something good.
Right.
You know, and that's pretty much, you know, what I like about it. You know, mm-hmm. It's just, you know, I believe in the law of attraction. You know, positive begets positive. You surround yourself around good people, good things happen. And so, yeah, it's just... everything's good right now.
That's, you know? Positive. That's really good. That's really good. Now, obviously, with everything that you're doing, there's always going to be that dark side or that element where it kind of creeps you out, because as a model, you have people that just want to get in your business. Mm-hmm. Can you share with us some experiences that kind of like, wow, this is not what I signed up for?
Yeah, like I was sharing with you earlier, year into it, I was like, okay, this is pretty cool. But then just weird things started happening. And it got to a point where I was like, you know what? I don't even want to do this. And my page, my Facebook page, was first a personal page. And then it started becoming towards like
business.
Like a fan page. And
yeah.
It just started kind of getting weird. And it was one of those things where I thought, I don't even want my page anymore. I think I just want to just disappear. Because that's how like things, I had somebody email me, and I guess they found it through my Facebook, saying, hi, Miss Victoria, are you interested in selling your undergarments?
What?
Like, oh, wow. So I kind of like traced, where did this person come from? This person doesn't have a profile pic, but he's obvious import, you know, follower. He loves, you know, so I kind of took it as a compliment, but I was like, oh, okay, that's kind of odd. But
you're like, how much?
I have friends telling me, just do it. Just
throw them like some crazy number, and if he'll pay for it, hey.
Make sure you use P.O. Box.
Yeah, exactly. And then one particular thing. This past birthday, I usually like to do like a celebration and an after party type of thing with, you know, friends and everything. And somebody put me on Craigslist, which was very interesting. And so I was getting different phone numbers, calls for personal escort type of situation.
Really? Someone actually did that?
Yes. I thought, is this the pure form of haterism, or should I just take it as a compliment? So it was very disturbing. I thought it would just stop. After 2 weeks of it, I was like, no. I had to call Craigslist, let them know, and it was off within a day or two. But I was thinking, who would... why? Wow, you really have a lot of time on your hands to do something like this. Mm-hmm. So it was, that's been pretty, just some weird things that, and like I said, I have small children, so I like not to expose them too much of, you know, because I don't want them to get a part of any of this weird stuff that goes on too, so.
But yeah, that's a first. We've never heard that story before, using Craigslist in a very manipulative way.
Yeah. Without permission.
Because... you really have no control over that. Mm-hmm. You have to contact them and tell them, hey, take it down. It's not me. Yeah. And they're...
I had to really, like, the people that were calling, ask them.
Yeah.
How'd you get this information? Just to find out where it rooted from.
Wow.
So.
That's crazy. Yeah. Well, that comes with the territory for you.
Yeah.
You can't really avoid that. Mm-hmm. But at the same time... you could just imagine some of the more higher end models, what they have to go through in terms of those sort of weird, creepy crap.
And you have to be careful. Like this, I don't like being by myself. Sometimes situations of, you know, being a woman, I always have somebody with me if I know.
And that's smart.
Yeah. So, because I've had some certain stalker situations too. So, yeah.
That. Exactly. That's why you brought Ren, even though she's on one leg.
She's got her crutches. She knows how to use her crutches.
That's extends her reach.
So, let's kind of talk about the real good stuff in terms of the community involvement. Break that down.
Recently, this will be my second summer working with... there's a lot of arts community that's coming out. We have once every... first Friday, they have a gathering downtown at one of the buildings, the Co-op, Cafe Co-op, and my friends over there, they've just promoting just good things that are happening. And I call it the hub because there's a lot of things happening down there. Even Jose Hernandez of Astronet has an office there. One of our councilman Tubbs has an office. So okay. There's a lot of things that are happening in that little area. Community also just, like I said, working with education. And then I have my future project coming up mid-August. I hope this will be my third year hosting.
All right. Let's talk about that.
This will be the 41st Filipino Barrio Fiesta. And there's just music, food. It's a two-day celebration in Stockton. And we usually do a kickoff after party on the Saturday event. I'll be out there from about 3 to 7. We've got some local Filipino rap artists that I'm going to kind of introduce.
Cool. So you're hosting?
Yes, I'm MC hosting it. And then after party, I believe I have a magician that's going to do some tricks. And maybe we'll do some, we'll figure out some other stuff. And I've got some good sponsors that are going to be backing me up for this too, so we're in the works with that.
Nice. And it's cool that you brought up a magician, because we had a magician here on the show. We got to invite him back. Mr. Joseph?
Gerald,
yeah.
You did in the back in the day too, right?
Oh, yeah, when I was like 12. It's always good to fool people. And when you see like Chris Angel and David Copperfield doing these tricks, it's like, wow, I could do that too.
Yeah.
But then after you find out how it's done, it's like, oh, it takes out the steam and mystery out of the whole thing. So to my co-hosts, I'll be asking this one question, and be ready with your question for Miss Valentine. Do you have any tattoos?
I have one.
Okay.
Yes. Do you want me? It's a little one.
Mm-hmm.
Can you guys? I don't know where the camera's at.
Right.
But it says.
It we
says,
can see it.
It says love.
It says
Chinese.
Love?
Yeah.
Okay.
My favorite word, love. Is kind of a challenge to my daughter because she's a beast, and she was like, Mom, if I get my first one, then you've got to get yours first. So I was like, okay, I'll do it. But this girl, she's got a big piece down her back. So
oh, really?
Hands down, she wins.
Okay.
So, yeah.
All right. Well, you kept it simple.
Yeah.
And representing. Nothing wrong with just one tattoo. All right. Who wants to take it away?
I'll go first. As a model, we all like to, look up magazines and stuff. Which fashion magazines, websites, blogs, and catalogs do you visit more often?
Vogue is always good. Cosmopolitan. I'm just a big fan of a lot of beautiful women.
Absolutely.
And, who is my favorite?
You don't have to name it now, because that's part of the 10 questions later.
So, like, the high-end magazines like Vogue and such.
Yeah, Mademoiselle. Yeah.
Yes. So. Me too, especially at the nail salon. It's like...
That's how you keep busy over there.
Exactly.
Yeah. I'm kind of curious. You mentioned before, like you said, I want to point out that you started a little bit later. But you said that you were actually interested in this when you were very young,
mm-hmm.
before you had your family. So
yes.
What actually interested you and pushed you in that at that time?
At the time, I think I had a lot of family and friends that were like, you have a nice look to you, you maybe should do, something like this. They would tell me I have an exotic look, and
a lot of people think... Well, you look pretty. You should do that.
Yeah, I was like, okay, yeah, sure. And then, when that time passed and I wasn't able to, here I am now and just...
Doing it.
Whatever, I can't. Yeah.
You're like, I can't believe it.
Did you have family or friends that were actually already in the modeling business when you were younger that were
I knew a few people that would do here and there, dabble with different things. And, of course, they would go with high-end agencies. And at the time, you've got to put a lot of money down. And from what I heard, it's like, if you put whenever people ask for money, then, it's not really legit. I've been pushing myself. This is a hustle. If anything, I'm putting money into my own self. If you want to break it down in that sense, if you put money into an agency or you put your money into your own work. So it's been a straight hustle. I don't know where it's going to lead me. And I'm just riding the wave.
Big Pippin.
And pursuing your dream. Right on.
Cool. So speaking of magazines, if Playboy called you tomorrow, would you do it?
I'm not a Playboy kind of girl. I admire beautiful women that can do it, but no, it wouldn't be my style. Yeah.
For maybe they put a car in front of you or something like that.
If it was
tastefully done.
Tastefully done. I forgot the word. Look at me. I don't even know. But it's I don't even know the word.
Well, is it more for family or is it more for personal reasons? I mean, like your own self.
For both.
Or is it just for family?
You don't want your family.
parents or your parents or your family coming back and saying like, hey, you did something that we didn't really approve of?
Yeah, and mostly it's my children. Yeah. You know, I've got four beautiful children. I want to shout out to them, Cheyenne, Sante, Hope, Nicholas. Love you guys. And so, you know, it's, you know, just maybe if I was younger, I say it all the time. If I didn't have any children, I probably even try to go even further than what, you know, what I'm doing underground, I guess you would call it. But yeah. So.
Cool.
Yeah.
Right on. Truth.
You know, you're in the game right now, and you know you got some experience, and you're in the modeling. What would you consider is probably one of the toughest roadblocks?
Toughest roadblocks. Ooh, good question. Is there's gonna be people that are gonna doubt you. There's gonna be people that are gonna weigh you down. But if you really believe, and this isn't any aspect, and I would tell my children, I tell my students, if you really believe you can do something, and you have people backing you up, then the sky's the limit. Do whatever you can and just push as much as you can until you can't do it anymore.
Also, I'd like to ask, you know, do you have any maybe advice for maybe people like maybe similar to your situation or maybe, you know, others that are, you know, wanting to get into modeling? Do you have any advice for these, you know, upcomers?
Well, let's add on to that because your daughter is on her way in that direction. Let's talk about that.
I will be promoting and managing my daughter, Cheyenne, and she wants to get into the import. That's how I started. So I'm going to kind of get her pushed that way and see where that goes with her.
How old is your daughter?
My daughter will be 18, 4th of July.
Oh, my gosh.
Awesome.
So, yeah. So she wants to see how things go with that. So
okay.
We'll be doing that in the near future.
Well, just to add on to what Stallion said, what if Playboy approached your daughter to be on there?
And you know what, she's a daddy's girl, so that's something that she and daddy would have to kind of talk about. But I think he already knows her interest in going into the import, and he told her, you know, you're starting to be a young adult, you're making your own decisions. That would be between, you know,
the dad.
Yeah.
Exactly.
The dad.
That's
and half.
The dad and his shotgun.
Oh, that's true.
I'm not gonna say anything.
That's yeah. True, the shotgun rules.
Yeah.
So, but she's 18 now, right?
She'll be this Thursday.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Well, happy birthday.
Is that 4th of July?
Yes, she's the 4th of July, baby.
Wow.
Bang, yeah. Bang, right?
Bang, bang.
Bang, bang.
Bang, bang.
Good
bang.
Fireworks there.
Very patriotic.
Do you have anything planned for her?
She will be with her father, or actually with me. We have different schedules. I think she's going to be with her friends. We just threw a big grad party and birthday party, so that was mom's gift to her. Had lechon and everything and
pig.
Yes,
nothing wrong with that. Mm-hmm. That's cool. So once again, if anyone wants to follow you on any social media sites, what's the tag name, screen names? Go ahead.
Just right now it's facebook.com Victoria Valentine. I'm promoting just different things that are happening with the community, my different projects that are coming up, and yeah, just look me up. Yeah.
Cool. All right. We're going to go ahead and take a quick music break and be back with the vaunted Q&A. Yes. This is going to be interesting, everyone. Hang tight. We'll be right back here on the Slam Show.
That's legit, I come to make a hit. I usually bust scratches for my brother, see I'm smooth, but I decided to get wrecked on this groove. As I provide this slide, you're going on a ride. I know the weather's nice, there's no need to play the outside. Guess who's on the flyer, the man of your desire. Pete Rock and see I'm smooth, all the honey dips admire. Beats are rough and rugged, Pete Rock is the creator. Now I'm busting raps as well, switching cross faders, making sure my sound hits from here to Grenada. Honey gave me skins, man, I told her friends I ate her. Oh waiter, I'll save the subject for later, but it's time to get wrecked with the creator. Like
like a stove, not into bone.
Yo, Pete, there's a girl on the phone.
Tell her to hold, cause I'm busy kicking rhymes to the rhythm. Fortified with soul, cause that's what I give them. Honey swim a line, cause I always seem to capture. Beats made a rupture, rhyme made a rapture. Far from illiterate, always seem to get a hit. If you try to step to this, don't even consider it. Skins when I want them, but only when I eat them. To set the record straight, I'll be damned if I eat them. Call me Pete Rock, I make the girls flop. And if you wanna beat like this, I got them in stock. So flow with the flow, because you know I'm good to go as I proceed to get wrecked on your stereo. Not an imitator, just a crowd motivator, but it's time to get wrecked with the creator. You'll see a spoon cut it up like this. Take a try and get a piece of the pie. If they give me one sec to get some wreck, never filled with anger, a good body banger. If you try to step to this, you'll get hung on my hanger. Before I say goodbye, suckers gave a good try, but point blank, you just can't see this. My word is beneficial, Pete Rock is the issue, and I know you know my style is official. I might give a scratch,
yes, cousin,
or I might kick a verse,
no question.
Either or, I can't be seen, honey, call me tall and lean. And if you care to stick around, I'll show you what I mean. Not an imitator, just a crowd motivator, but it's time to get wrecked with the creator. To get wrecked with the creator. Get wrecked with the creator. The creator. See us move, get busy.
Yeah, a little throwback classic there. The creator, CL Smooth and Pete Rock.
Oh boy, Pete Rock.
That's the joint right there, brothers. Mm-hmm. I love it, love it. All right, welcome back to the Slam Show. This is a segment which we call the Vaunted Q&A. And we definitely are going to put the lovely Miss Valentine on the spot with 10 questions and see how well she does. If she's quick on the trigger or hesitant.
Bang, bang.
You're going to have to copyright that and make t-shirts, bro.
Can't. It's been said. Pops. All the Wayans brothers says it all the time.
That's right.
Bang, bang.
But see, he does it his way, and Truth does it his way. So there could be a...
He's already trademarked it.
Did he?
Yeah, way back in the day, even before Friday.
What'd you do, go to Washington and check the works? Copyright freaking files?
He said it at Tommy T's when he was... doing a stand-up.
Probably. All right. You ready?
Sure.
Vicky?
Yes.
I'll go ahead and start this off. Number one, what's your favorite song right now?
I am a big reggae fan, and I love Hawaiian reggae. Anawea. I love Higher Than the Clouds is my favorite song.
Ooh,
right now.
You got to meet our good friend Rilma out of San Jose. She's a big reggae fan. Nice. Shouts out to Rilma. She goes
no,
out to
Rilma, no shout out to you.
She loves to go to all these concerts.
Yes.
Yeah,
she's been in the hiding.
We actually had a Hawaiian artist, Wakane?
Yeah, Wakane. Yes. Yes.
Remember her?
Mm-hmm.
She's awesome. So she's, yeah, look her up.
Yeah. Her show appearance is archived. So if you check it out, she actually played live here in the studio.
Oh, awesome.
With her ukulele.
Oh, I love the ukulele. Yes.
Yeah, it was awesome. So I'll hook you up with that link. All right.
What is the weirdest pickup line a guy or a girl has used on you?
I can think of one thing that was interesting. One guy wanted to thumb wrestle me. So I really thought that was pretty interesting.
Where was this at?
This was in Manteca a couple years
the
back.
Water slides?
No.
Damn,
no,
I want
to
go.
We were actually adults, but it was. I thought it was pretty creative that he came up to me and was like, hey, would you like to thumb wrestle? And
should have said
like,
tongue
sure.
wrestle.
He just wanted to touch you. Ew.
That's crazy.
thumb wrestling.
Yeah, I'm pretty playful. I like fun stuff like that. So I thought it was interesting.
Did you win?
Take notes.
Yes, I did. I won. I may have cheated, but I won.
Cool.
All right, number three. Your favorite store to shop?
Well, since my sponsor for this lovely outfit is Fashion Avenue of Stockton, California on West Lane, that is my favorite store at this point.
Okay.
I love their stuff. I always get their stuff, and they hook me up and make me look nice. So, yes.
Simple enough.
Yes.
Easy.
Cool. What movies can you watch over and over again?
My kids, we just watched Nacho Libre the other night.
Jack Black.
And nice. We can watch that movie over and over. Yes.
Is that the only one?
Oh, gosh. I don't know. I love all kinds of movies, music. I don't know.
Do you like going to the movies?
Yes. Yes, I do.
Once a week?
It's been a while, but I do want to see This Is the End. I'm a really comedy fanatic.
Yeah.
So I want to see that.
Yeah, soon. Stallion has raved to the high heavens about watching it again and again.
Then we'll have to go.
There you go. There you go. Maybe you could do it on Sunday.
Late night?
Oh, brother. All right, number five. What's your idea of a hot romantic date?
Oh, gosh. I like really quiet settings. I'm a very conversationalist. I like to get to know a person. So something that's very...
So JT Rock is out the question, right? JT Rock is one of our insiders. And he loves just to...
He makes 6 G's a minute, though.
Yeah, 6 G's a minute.
He can conversate? What?
And he's driving the bus, pointing off the landmarks.
He's like, yo.
Yo.
Let's fuck.
Oh.
Take it to the Philippines.
Oh, yeah. He runs the Philippines. I forgot about that. But I'm sorry. Go ahead and break it down.
What was the question? Now I got distracted.
Yeah, JT Rock has a tendency to do that.
Oh, you throw him under the bus.
His
JT Tours bus.
Yeah, just something very simple. I'm a very simple girl.
Okay.
Yeah, just nice
Burger King.
Lighting. No, not
McDonald's.
Burger King.
Come on,
no,
man.
A nice little candlelit dinner, you know, maybe a nice little slow dance, you know.
Slow dance?
Yeah.
What are we, eighth grade dance or
yeah,
something?
Yeah, play some sweat right here. Nobody
the high school prom. Let's
you
go.
Know, we'll go between, you know, not too close. You got to...
Have that distance.
One book,
distance,
one exactly. book length away.
So you have a chaperone at your high school exactly. dance, and then you're good to go.
I have my chaperones on my dates.
Ren's coming.
That's too much.
So what is your favorite alcohol drink or regular drink if you don't drink alcohol?
Right now is the vodka and cranberry. I've been doing a lot of vodka and cranberry.
What kind of vodka?
Smirnoff. Yeah.
What do you think of that, Karma?
It's good. Grey Goose is
most
good,
popular.
You know,
Grey Goose is nasty. Smirnoff is actually the most popular liquor, which is I'll drink it, but you know, yeah. It's just a mixing drink.
What is Karma's top three vodkas right now to recommend to Vicky?
Depends what you're drinking with. So if you want it straight, Stoli Elite always. So if you're just gonna drink vodka as vodka, Stoli Elite. If you're gonna mix it with a regular. Just juice or like I do with the Zion's energy drinks. It's going to be New Amsterdam or it'll be Smirnoff, which is a very good one. So it's a low end, not low end, but middle end, not very expensive. If you're going to do with the high end middle class, it would be a Ketel One and Tonic.
Nice.
He is our resident mixologist.
Awesome.
Chemist.
And chemist. Yeah, yes. So he has a tendency to blow you up on accident. That's for sure. All right, number seven. What's the weirdest phobia you have?
Oh, my. Well, I like to... I didn't get my license until I was 26 years old.
Okay.
I was scared to drive. That was my biggest anxiety. Yeah.
But so you're not... You're still
no, but
okay
now,
to,
now I'm okay.
Yeah. Well, we're talking about something that...
Something
current. That
current?
Spiders, snakes, ghosts...
Snakes are scary. I don't like scary movies.
Really?
I don't know. Yeah, I don't really watch scary movies anymore.
Is it because it kind of like messes up your head after watching?
I just
watching?
Don't like worrying about shutting the light off and something coming out from under the bed.
Well,
I don't
ask
know.
Is it a gore movie or is it like more
just,
of like a
you
scare
know, honestly,
or like fright
movie?
You know,
honestly, the ones that really get me are the psychic
okay, so like
the ones that mess
activity.
With your head.
Grudge.
Are the ones that scare me because it's like it messes with this the okay. psyche.
So yeah. Like the Friday the 13th, Freddy Krueger, Michael Myers.
Yeah, that's kind of like, but it's the ones that really
Evil
mess
Dead.
With your head that it's like, wow.
Evil Dead, yeah. Don't
yeah,
watch
the
that one.
Suspense thrillers. I could tell you're kind of shaking up just by the thought of it. It's like, boy.
Then don't watch World War Z with Brad Pitt.
Is that a scary movie or is it? Is it comedy?
Hey, no, talk to the mic. Truth, talk to the mic.
Yeah, what are you doing, man? You leaning back?
I'm leaning, man.
We can't hear you.
Lean back.
As you were saying?
Is World War Z a comedy or?
No, it's not a comedy.
Yeah, it's a horror flick.
Oh, mm-hmm. Oh okay. I was joking. Yeah.
With like zombies, but you know, if you're not into that, then it's going to trip you out.
Spoiler alert.
Have you seen a commercial?
I didn't know it was horror.
I mean, have you seen
I thought it was just an apocalypse movie.
No.
That was Brad Pitt being sexy.
Interesting.
Yeah.
On the commercials, you see the zombies on the commercials. I mean, it's all over there.
Gotcha. So what was the last horror movie that you seen that you could remember?
This is how bad it's been. The Ring. That's how wow. long it's been.
Yeah, that could kind of fuck you up right
That's
there.
That's why I thought, yeah. I don't think I want to watch anymore.
Yeah, seeing that chick come out of the TV and...
and the spinning circle.
Yeah, the spinning circle.
So, yeah, that's been a long time.
Was it the screen?
Everything.
Yeah, that could petrify you. That's for sure.
All right. Who is your celebrity crush, guy or
I'm
girl?
I'm glad you asked that because yesterday I took a nice little cat nap and I dreamt of the lovely Johnny Depp.
Johnny Depp?
As Tonto?
Yes. Yes. No, as... I don't know, but he's
Captain
looking
Jack
good
Swallow?
For... He's rocking it. Being 50 years old, he's very hot to me. Yes.
He's that old?
Yes.
He's 50.
No one wears
makeup.
So
eyeliner in all of his movies. But yeah. Even 21 Jump Street.
And the thing with Johnny Depp is I can't really honestly figure out his natural voice because he's always in character in a lot of his roles. Yeah. I mean, with the Pirates of the Caribbean and now with Tonto on the Lone Ranger, I can't figure it out.
I just thought it was kind of funny, though, that he's got this English accent going on.
I was
going
to say that. He has a British... That? He does, because he lives in London.
Oh,
He did live in London at one point.
And maybe that's what it was, because I'm thinking, does that happen? Like, Madonna does kind of the same thing.
Exactly.
I was watching YouTube, because after I had that dream, I'm YouTubing everything on him, and I'm like, he has some kind of accent going on.
It's like the slang of his voice. Like, even when he had the award show, I don't know, it was MTV. Is kind of in like between Jack Sparrow and somebody else.
Yeah, exactly.
But that's the way he talks.
Yeah, and that's where I'm kind of figuring out, is he always trying to be a character on interviews, accepting awards? It's like
you're high in a way, but you're tired. But
yeah,
you
he comes across
like a hippie high.
But yeah, he's
very mellow.
Yeah, he is aging pretty damn well.
He is very good looking, yes.
So, without a doubt, that's...
Johnny. I've loved him since 21 Jump Street.
Really?
Yeah.
Just right there, alone with him, what would you do?
Bastos.
So, you're talking about the movie?
Oh, you're shaking! You're shaking! I saw the shake!
I need the fan.
All right, so, let's just kind of go on the girl end. If you were... Yeah. Is there an attraction for a certain female?
I think just... There's an elegance and beauty about women, and I just made a post about this the other day, but I love strong, beautiful, intelligent women.
Sigourney Weaver?
With her bald head.
Not that strong.
Angelina Jolie is very exquisite to me.
Okay.
She's very beautiful. She holds herself up well, and I believe she's some kind of ambassador of one of these countries, but I think she's very gorgeous. Yeah.
You see, like, Tomb Raider or Mr. and Mrs. Smith?
Yes.
Right, you would go, or pre Billy Bob, or after Brad.
I think she was I've always thought she was gorgeous.
So even now,
she's beautiful.
How about Jennifer Aniston?
There's one if I can cut it in there. Well, Charlize Theron.
She's been in a few
superheroes. She was in Hancock.
And she's that strong, hot woman.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She's a gorgeous girl, too.
You just want her on your cock.
And obviously, Karma's girlfriend, Scarlett Johansson.
Now she's a superhero, too.
What do you think of her? The hesitation already answers it.
Do you even know who she is?
Watch a movie,
woman. Yeah.
Goodness. Cool.
Cool. You.
All right. I'll go.
It is your turn.
Oh, man. It's the heat. It's throwing my numbering off.
Number 9.
Do you believe in UFOs, ghosts?
Sisters?
Add it on.
Yeah, I believe there's life out there. I think there's other dimensions of things that are going on. Yeah.
Have you had any personal experiences or think that you may have?
I will tell you.
Because obviously, being Filipino, there is a lot of folklore and history.
I really didn't believe that my mother would tell me that her mother would come and visit her.
Right.
And so she would tell me my grandmother smoked a certain type of cigarette. And she had told me it was her anniversary of her birthday or her death. And she was like, Mama's coming to visit. And I was like, okay. She's like, she's smoking her cigarettes. So I'm thinking, okay, whatever, Mom. Because I'd hear these stories growing up. And so one day I sat next to her. She, you know, my mom was a big smoker. Both, rest in peace, my mom and dad are passed away. But she was smoking her cigarette. Well, she was sitting at the table, which she always does, smoking cigarettes. So I'm sitting there with her, and I stand up to go to use the restroom, and a smoke just blows in my face. And I'm thinking,
what?
A mom, like, I'm looking at her. She's not even doing it. And then I was like, whoa.
All right. You were kind of gearing it towards you're going to smell it, but
no,
your actual
it blew
smoke.
In my face. And then going into the restroom, I think it was another day, I was going towards the bathroom and it happened to me again. And at the time, my ex-husband at the time, he was my boyfriend, he wasn't believing any of this, and she did the same thing to him. So she was just making her presence know that she's there and she's with us and she's watching over us. So, yeah.
That's
yeah.
crazy. You said he was in the bathroom. I hope it wasn't something else she blew into. It was like, you said I was in the bathroom.
I don't know. I'm like going to the restroom.
No, was this your childhood home or
yes,
just?
It was
okay.
a childhood home. Okay. I was a teenager at the time, and I just would always hear the stories. And when it happened, I was like, okay, I believe you, Mom. All right. Yeah. So I believe, yeah.
There you go.
Cool. There's a couple in here right now. So. do you have any hidden talents? Can you sing, rap? Breakdance?
You know, Filipinos, we're always talented about something. I don't know. Just
karaoke?
Like to, freestyle. Karaoke right here.
Freestyle right now.
No, I don't.
Sing some Jocelyn Enriquez.
You have the beat. You know you do.
I like art. I have a little bit of drawing skills.
Really?
Yeah, just a little. Played one song on the uke once. My sister's a singer, so we kind of collaborated at times. Love to do the work with this lady. She's a gorgeous, you know, beautiful singer. Just little things like that. I don't know.
All right. Yeah. Fair enough. Fair enough. And do we have a bonus question prepared?
I do.
Always.
No truth.
I got, what's it called? Since you're an import model.
Talk closer to the mic.
Since you're an import model, do you have a favorite car?
I am honestly, I love all cars. I don't know what it is. I guess it's the art form. I was telling you earlier, too, with modeling, too, I look at it as an art form. So, I mean, I love just all types of cars, from the imports to the classics. Yeah.
You have a specific favorite one?
Yeah, let's break it down.
Yeah, one that just popped in your head the moment I said that.
And you know
it's got four wheels, four seats, and a steering wheel.
Awesome. You know what? I feel so stupid right now because I know what it is. You guys, the El Camino. I love El Caminos. You know, I think it's the fact that it's because it's a truck and it's a car. So I don't know, for whatever reason, like, that has always drawn to me, that it's just different. And I just really think they're nice.
How about Ford Mustangs?
I had one at one time, yes.
Okay.
A convertible at one time, yes.
All right.
Those are beautiful.
Good memories?
Yes, good memories.
Woo!
Nice red hot one.
Ooh,
white
red.
Top.
Bang, bang.
Yeah.
So obviously with the kids, you're not going to have a conventional vehicle. What is it? Is it a minivan? Is
now,
it SUV?
Well, I've
town
got
country.
I've got like a little Toyota Celica.
Okay.
That squeezes
that's
all
the kids
in. Exactly. It's like a little clown car. Like kids are coming out. But I also have like a SUV that I'm gonna try to squeeze the kids into that. They're
Soccer
getting
mom.
Bigger as it is. You know?
See, what you need to do is trick it out. Like Pit My Ride. Just put like some rims and the
Murder
system.
It out.
That'd be nice.
Yeah, so you could be that hip model mom for all your children.
Yes, yeah, they're just kind of embarrassed, you know. They're just like,
get some spinners on her.
Well, see, the thing is you even mentioned it on the pre-show, is that you're always mistaken as being the sister to your eldest, right?
My eldest, she's loving this right now, you know. You're watching Cheyenne. Yeah, yeah. I've the last several years since she's about 13, 14. That's been, is that your sister? No, that's my daughter.
And experiences with that. I know maybe you don't want to talk about it, but I want to see where you were with your daughter and all of a sudden.
You know, all my friends out there, you guys know which ones I'm talking about. They do the whole, oh, she's going to be 18 soon. So it's one of those things, yeah, you just need to stop. So they play that little trick with me and they know that it pisses me off.
Have you maybe you now have gotten invites to like those parties and so forth, like, oh, bring your mom or
the
anything
city
like
nights,
that
come on.
Yeah, my daughter for a while was like, Mom, please don't walk on campus.
Really?
You know, for, yeah, she was telling me like the beginning of her year of high school. Was like, Mom, please just don't come on campus.
Well, it makes total sense. You're going to come on. You're going to drop the jaws of all the senior kids and freshmen.
They all want to come over.
Literally. They're like, oh, when's, can we have study over at your house?
Has your daughter ever took advantage of you, asking you like to bring booze to a party or anything?
Mom. Well, actually, she's actually a really good girl. I don't know what she does with, you know, kids do their things. But
like right now?
She but no, I not.
She's just screaming you just to follow you right now. It's like, oh, she's not going to be around here for another 2 hours.
She's over there on the other side.
Vicky, this is off the record. He's going off in his own tantrum. Karma is trying to get down to the nitty gritty. That's how he that's how he gets down. But yeah, overall, you're gonna have to expect that because you're doing the modeling. She's gonna go into the modeling, and you might be the first mom and daughter team to really blossom out in the Northern California scene. That would be a spread right there, not literally. But
that would be an interesting concept. You know, we'll see where it goes with that. You know.
Yeah. Cool. All right. We're going to go ahead and take a quick music break and be back with the shouts and plugs to close out this episode of The Slam Show. Everyone, hang tight.
Saying, do me now, ooh, don't style. Do me now, do me now. I need your love.
Yeah, that's brand new. Do Me Now by Kay Roosevelt featuring Hit-Boy here on The Slam Show. This is the Shouts and Plug segment, and as we always do, we kick it off with Mr. Karma.
Well, as always, I'd like to thank my hosts, my co-hosts, that lets me sit in my corner every week. Truth, thank you for joining us. Remy out there, just being quiet. And then Victoria Valentine, just hanging out.
Are you cupcaking? Because you're like kind of enunciating.
Yeah, yeah, I'm trying to.
Point the balance.
Do you want to
come
sit next to me?
Yes. He wants to come. All right.
He wants to sit next to me.
Is it?
Move over, Truth.
Oh!
She likes exotic. Oh! All right, so Slam and Sam. I'm sorry, Lady Sage, hey. And for of course DJ Stallion, my brother from another mother. Thank you very much.
Oh, that's touching.
Lady Sage.
Well, I want to give a big shout out to our special guest, Victoria, and Ren, who's sitting patiently here. Thank you for taking the time out with your busy schedule to be with us, and especially with this 200-degree weather here in the studio.
Believe me, thank you. Yeah.
Death Valley.
Yes, and of course to my crew, Slam, Stallion, and Karma, and to our special guest co-host, Mr. Truth, Philippine News.
Bang, bang.
And of course, to all of our sponsors, shout out to you guys. It's a long list. I'll let Stallion deal with that. But you can also get a complete list at tvepn.com.
Cool.
And our crew, Mr. Slam and Sam, Bad Karma this time, Lady Sage, our special guest, I'm going to do like Karma, Victoria Valentine, and our homegirl, Ran. Truth, thanks for coming out. And next time you lean back, more towards the mic.
Lean forward.
Pop the collar.
Lean forward.
There you go.
A little closer. And our sponsors, Bugasaw, What's Up, Lorenzo, and Cleo, they're out in China right now and doing big things, getting some more guns for us to give out to our guests and friends. Kinders, What's Up? Davino's, Little J's, What Up, Aaron? I know it was hot in there when we went in there, but you held it down. He was banging out burgers. Left and right when I went in. It was crazy.
130 degrees, huh?
It was 130 degrees up in there, man. He was doing his thing. Drinkware, What Up, Ant? BPM Supreme, Natural Laugh Foods, Perfect Tan, Nana Empire. Online is Elisa, DJ Pete Fonseca, DJ Mark Savage, and my parents.
Right on, Stallion. True, take it away.
All right, here we go.
Kiss the mic, please.
Yeah, good.
Shouts out.
There you go. That's the way.
There you go. Bang, bang. What's it called? Shouts out to everybody here in the Slam Show. Slam, Sage, Karma, and Stallion. And shouts out to our lovely guests. You got Valentine, right? Miss Valentine right here. And you got a lovely Ren over there, the ultimate math teacher.
Nice. Hottest teacher in the 209.
There you go. That's a nice tag. Hottest teacher in the 209. People are like, bang. I didn't see her.
Shouts out to my family. Shouts out to PST Gear and Mike Pablo. Shouts out to Fruition Clothing, Andrew, Jack, and Marlon. And for more information, go to www.fruitionclothing.bigcartel.com.
How do you spell that?
FRTN Clothing. Big Cartel.
It's like Fosachi. Fosachi.
Bang, bang. All right. Shouts out to Fresca, Alan Manuel, Dean and Ricky from Fan TV. Shouts out to Stephanie Laxamana, Ryan Macanana, Ryan Largo, Daniel Del Rosario, who got in, I think, an accident.
Daniel?
Yeah.
When?
Probably this weekend, but he's doing better.
I need to give him a call.
Yeah.
Interesting. Yeah. Thanks for letting us know.
Yeah, no problem. Shouts out to you, Daniel. Megan Nazareno, super champion. It's the whole Filipino staff crew. And a shout, and you can follow me on Twitter at TruthIsGuerra. And also, my special shout out here to Cyrus. He's an upcoming fighter. He has the quickest hands for like probably 10 years old or even younger than 10. But yeah, Cyrus, he has like the fastest hands out there. Check him out. Team Cyrus 1208 at YouTube. So shouts out to him. Shouts out to Patrick and his whole fam. So it is what it is. Bang, bang.
All right.
Speaking of bang, bang, you told me you were killing bugs with a gun.
Oh, yeah, dude. What's it called? Shouts out to Bug Assault. Dude, I was roasting some roaches, man. Bang, bang. I was like shooting them, and it was crazy. They're all like, they all get jacked.
Did you
up.
Eat them after?
No, why would I eat roaches?
I don't know.
I don't eat roaches.
They got some salt on it already.
Because we eat dog. Why wouldn't we want to eat roaches?
Oh, man. Oh, man.
It's a perfect day.
That was good.
He does good with the black dog.
Man. But yeah, shouts out to Bug Assault. Yeah, they're dope. You should check out their guns, man. You know, bang, bang.
You get a little round of applause for that one. Truth. Okay. Vicky, go ahead and take it away. Your shout.
I just want to thank you guys for recognizing me and wanting to bring me on the show. Like I was telling you earlier, that it's just surreal that you would even want me here. And I'm just like just thankful for everything that's, you know, been going on for you to ask me on here. I just really am truly thankful for all of you guys. I want to shout out to Jordan. He had texted me earlier saying, I think I'm the only one watching. So he just wanted me to shout out to him. And all my friends and family that have been supporting and watching out there and followers. And Mac Shot Photography, Mike Byerly, Frankenmuffin, Cafe Co-op, the Barrio Fiesta for you know, all the stuff they've done for me. Kevin Moore. Oh God, there's just so many. And I'm just thankful for the long run. And if I missed any of you guys,
Reggie.
I really do appreciate it. Reggie.
Yes.
lovely Reggie. Yeah, there's just so many things, so many people.
Yeah, Reggie's a character. We love him to death.
Oh, he's
and every
special.
Time we're over at the VU. you've been
you
there, right?
Out. I'm just kidding.
Actually, I have not.
You haven't? Well, we're
it's okay. We're giving her free passes. Not that she needs it.
Would you like to go with us?
Can I see? Like, night. I went through the door, night. And then like I wasn't allowed because there's too many people. So, so I semi kind of went. No.
All right.
Karma got a semi there.
No. Champagne room all the way.
Oh my goodness.
Thank you, Reggie.
All right. I'd like to thank my entire crew, Sage, Stallion, Karma, our special guest co-host, Mr. Ezgara, a.k.a. Mr. Philippine, a.k.a. Yeah. Mr. Truth.
Bang, bang.
A.k.a. Mr.
Bang, bang.
Thank you, Mr. Bang, bang. Our special guest, Victoria, thank you very much for making the trip out here with this 300-degree weather that we're having. And
went up 100 degrees. Mm-hmm. I said 200.
That's how it feels.
Six and cheese a minute.
And the lovely Ren, your assistant, being able to come and accompany you in her condition is a great thing, as a testament to her drive to be able to say, hey, I'm not going to let those guys on the slam show take advantage of you. I want to be there and make sure you're protected.
That's my sister.
Yeah, so much props to Ren for making that happen. Our insiders that are online, Baller Impact, JT Rock, thank you very much for all your support. Yes.
Why are you laughing, Truth?
Bill Gates.
Yeah. Six G's of it. We'll tell you about all that later, Vicky. And our...
Show on the Facebook page.
Our Mixed Time DJ of the week is DJ Scoop from Houston. Thank you very much for putting together a great mix. All the sponsors and affiliates, everyone that's in the chat room interacting with us, and everyone that's not in the chat room, continue to have the viewing support. Be sure to like our Facebook page at TVEPN The Slam Show, which enables you to be at the... in the running for a free prize that we do each week. And this week we have a nice prize pack that Miss Valentine was able to put together with some sponsors of hers.
Oh my God, I forgot. Mark is gonna kill me.
Yeah, go ahead.
He gave me all kinds of t-shirts and CDs. Mark for Death, he's an underground hip-hop artist. We just did a video 2-3 weeks ago, so I've got some lovely giveaways.
Cool. We'll put that together for this week's winner. So without further ado, I'll go ahead and give you the bowl. You pick out a name and read it off. So we'll see how this one goes. You ready?
Yes.
Shake it up a little bit. Oh, actually have Mr. Bang Bang shake it and you pull it out.
Yeah.
How'd that sound?
Yeah.
The sound pretty.
Reach in.
Go ahead and read it.
Yes.
Okay. And the winner is Zaint Santa Maria. Zaint.
Congratulations. You are this week's winner.
Woohoo!
We're going to put together something for you that Miss Valentine was able to contribute to our gift bags and so forth. Thank you very much for doing that. You are the bomb. That's for sure. All right. That does it for this episode of The Slam Show. For myself and everyone here, let the rhythm take you. We'll see you next week.
Peace.
Peace.
People to people, party to place. Having the time of your life is all in your face. Hands in the sky while snatching, catching the vibe. We go uptown, downtown, that's how we ride. Yo, strip mall is where we get at.
the top dog, the top off while driving the train. Players, too many to name. Some gain recognition and even fame. Some go slow and some may go fast. But me and my partners, we dip when we dash. And we flipping the cash, drip, zipping the bag. Trippy slip when he crash. All good, never bad. All you never had. Dreams do come true for me and you. So let it do what it do. Boy, let me say, it's the ride of your life. And if you're rolling with me, I tell you, I do you right. So put your seatbelt on and let your hair hang low. And if you wet what we wet, then I suggest you let it go. People to people, party to place. Having the time of your life is all in your face. Hands in the sky while snatching, catching the vibe. We go uptown, downtown, that's how we ride. Strip mall is where we be at. It's the top dog, the top off while driving the train. Bass, boom, let it go. Just tell me how you play. I never give up. I do this thing like every day. And I break it down in every way. Oh man, I got carried away. But anyway, I'ma say I feel good every day. Every way, la-da-da. I make the beat, ba-ba-da-ba. Pop the heat.